At number 10 with Oliver. Oliver was a chimpanzee that was acquired by American trainers in 1960. Now, they instantly thought something was strange about him. His face was too flat, his hair was too thin, his eyes were a strange color, and he also did something that no other chimp does. Oliver walked upright on two legs. This led his owners to speculate that he was the product of crossbreeding between a human and a chimp known as a humanzee. It might sound crazy, but Dr. Gordon Gallup of the University of New York said there was reason to suspect that Oliver may be a human-chimpanzee hybrid. Humans and chimps share at least 99% of their basic biological chemistry. Oliver died in 2012, with the scientific community deeming him to be a normal chimp, although a full, complete DNA test was never done. Next up at number 9 now, we have the human-pig chimera. In January 2017, scientists announced they had created a real-life human-pig hybrid. The embryos they made were only a tiny bit human, less than 0.001%. The rest was all pig, but crucially, it was a hybrid. They only lasted for 28 days, but the scientists felt it was a step in the right direction. They hoped that eventually animals could even grow entire human organs ready for use. How does this one make you guys feel? I know it can be pretty divisive. At number 8 now, we have the Ningyo. The Ningyo is the Japanese equivalent of a mermaid, and in one special shrine, people claim they have a specimen. It's been dated to over 1,400 years old and bears a striking resemblance to the artwork depicting these creatures. Some visitors to the shrine claim that it's made out of stone or wood, but that's incorrect. It is genuine organic matter. Here's the thing though, other people say it's most likely advanced taxidermy, with people splicing them together after death. What do you guys think though? At number 7 now, we have the mouse ear. In 2016, Japanese scientists announced they had grown a human ear on the back of a rat. They used human stem cells injected into the rat. The stem cells developed into human cartilage tissue and molded in the rat into the shape of an ear. Now, the aim for all of this is to be able to help children with facial abnormalities and give them fully grown body parts from their own DNA so it won't get rejected. Coming in at number 6 now, we have the half sheep. In June 2017, villagers from South Africa said that the offspring of a local sheep was sent by the devil, but to others though, it looked like a human sheep hybrid. When the villagers called in expert help, even the chief director of the veterinary services said that he thought it looked oddly human. The vets then took it away to study. They suspected it was due to a fever in the sheep's mother that caused the deformity, but the village elders maintained that it was sent by the devil and was born after a coupling between a man and a sheep. Alright, next up at number 5 now, we have the horse baby of Benin. This 2012 story comes from the city of Benin in Nigeria, where a woman gave birth to an offspring that looked a lot like a horse. This all happened in a church, with witnesses saying the mother had to hold onto someone's leg as she went into labor. The priest of the church then warned everyone around to stay clear of the demonic object. In reality though, it is probably just a deformed human pregnancy, or even a total fake, because we only really have this video to go on. Coming in at number 4 now, we have the Russian lamb. This claim comes from a farm in southern Russia in 2015, where a sheep gave birth to a lamb that basically looks like an old man, to be honest. See for yourself though. The video shows the lamb not long after it was born, making sort of odd grunting noises as the mother tried to clean it. The farmer was shocked, and some of the locals thought it was actually a human-sheep hybrid. The general consensus though is that it's just a facial deformity, as the rest of the lamb seemed to be in working order. Moving on to number 3 now, we have the Thai cow. In 2010, a story emerged from Thailand of a cow that had given birth to a very human-like creature. The local people poured baby powder on the body and burned incense in the hopes of cleansing the area of evil. The mouth, head, and stomach were certainly quite human-looking, while the hooves were clearly cow-like. Although the local people think this is some evil hybrid, there's a good chance it is just a deformed cow calf. I also think the online hysteria was made worse with these pictures because of the baby powder. It really made this thing look even creepier. At number 2 now, we have the sheep with human livers. In 2005, researchers at the University of Nevada created sheep with organs containing millions of human cells. They announced they could grow livers in sheep that were 20% human. As with other examples we've talked about, the researchers used embryonic stem cells, and they did it for the same reason, to eventually develop fully grown human organs on demand. And finally at number 1, we have the human mouse. The results of this experiment were announced in 2015. Scientists thought they had found a DNA sequence responsible for making human brains bigger than other animals. So they took the human gene for this and the chimpanzee version of the gene and put them into mice. The ones with the chimpanzee brain DNA didn't really have much bigger brains, but the ones with human sequences grew 12% bigger. The mice would not have gone on to achieve human levels of intelligence, but these human-mouse hybrid brains could be a step in that direction.
Starting off this countdown, we have the Growler Bear. The Growler Bear, or the Pizzly Bear, is a cross between a polar bear and a brown grizzly bear. This actually happened naturally in the wild, which is kind of hard to believe. Basically, because of climate change destroying the bear's habitats, they started breeding with each other out of desperation, which is actually pretty sad. It's believed that the first growler bear was discovered in 2006. On April 16th, 2006, a hunter named Jim Martell was out hunting when he captured a growler bear. At first, he thought it was just a polar bear, but officials took a look at it and noticed it had strange features. Later, it was determined to be a growler bear. Or Pizzly Bear. It's really funny to say. In our ninth spot, we have a Zorse. Any guesses as to what this animal is mixed with? Well, it's a mix between a zebra and a horse. Or sometimes a donkey too. Other people refer to them as Zebula, or Zebrule, or a zebra mule. These animals were created after crossbreeding a male zebra with a female horse. The offspring look more like a horse than a zebra, but they still got the identifying stripes. The first Zorse was created during the 19th century by Charles Darwin. Now, they are still around to this day, but they are extremely rare. This is because Zorses are infertile, or sterile. They can't reproduce on their own. So the only way to get more of these bad boys is to get someone to crossbreed them themselves. Moving on, number 8, we have the Jaglion, or Jagleon, I don't know. It's a kind of a weird name, not gonna lie, but this animal is a cross between a jaguar and a lion. And these are actually naturally born. The first Jaglion was unintentionally bred. It happened when a lion and a jaguar coexisted in the same zoo together. They were raised together and, you know, one thing led to another and boom, baby Jaglion. Not gonna lie, these things are beautifully terrifying. They are so unique and cool looking, but also I would never want to come face to face with one. Now, let me share with you a quick little love story between a jaguar named Diablo and a lion named Lola. The two were raised side by side and were inseparable. When Lola got mature, they kept Diablo away from her so that they would never mate. But whenever they were apart, both animals would grow depressed. It got so bad to the point where Lola wouldn't even eat. So they brought them back together, and bada bing, bada boom, they had two babies together. So cute. Moving on to number 7, we have the Human Z. It is so weird and uncomfortable putting this one on the list. But a Human Z is a cross between a human and a chimpanzee. Yeah, I already know what you're thinking, but no, not that. Let me explain. Serious attempts have been made throughout the years to cross a chimp with a human. Since we're so similar in a genetic way, people believe that it's possible to do this. Ilya Ivanich Ivanov was the first person to attempt to create a human-chimp hybrid. I believe he started in 1918 and continued these experiences throughout the 1920s. During that time, the Soviet Union was also doing the same experiments. In 2019, rumor has it that a team of researchers from the Salk Institute for Biological Studies in the US successfully completed this. It's kind of creepy, I know. In our sixth spot, we have the Iron Age pig. This is a big, mean old pig, literally. So the Iron Age pig is a cross between a domestic pig and a wild boar. That's just like so wrong to me on so many levels, like poor little Miss Piggy. Now look at this thing. It's huge and looks tough and mean. In fact, they are considered very hostile animals. It's because wild boars are typically more aggressive. That's one of the traits that gets passed along to their offsprings. Now, they get their name because this pig has many characteristics of domesticated animals from the Iron Age period. Hello, there you go, Iron Age pig. It's quite fascinating. These pigs are generally bred in Europe for the sole purpose of selling and eating them. We're now at our fifth and halfway mark with the green sea slug. As strange as this one is, it's actually really interesting. Honestly though, this has to be the weirdest hybrid on this list. And that's because it's part animal and part plant. Yeah, it's a mix between a sea slug and algae. Yeah, algae. This sea slug was going around eating algae, and eventually the algae became part of its DNA. It's very strange. Soon, green sea slugs were born and contained chlorophyll, just like a plant. In fact, this is the first animal able to make chlorophyll like a plant. They literally can turn solar energy into food. Again, it's quite weird, but also fascinating. In our fourth spot, we have the wolfin, which is really fun and funny to say. So a wolfin is a mix between an Atlantic bottlenose dolphin and a false killer whale. In fact, these are considered very, very rare. The first recorded wolfin was born in 1981 in Tokyo SeaWorld, but sadly, he passed away after 200 days. Now, the first wolfin born in the US was at Sea Life Park in Hawaii in 1985, but she had trouble reproducing. Her baby wolfins sadly passed away. Some say they have seen wolfins out in the wild, but these sightings have never been confirmed. But if you do see one, it's very rare. Coming in at number three, we have the EnviroPig. Okay, this one, I take it back. This one is probably the weirdest one on this list. Basically, an EnviroPig is an environmentally friendly pig. Basically, pigs' excrements are high in phosphorus. This phosphorus then ends up in lakes and rivers and oceans and can cause a boom of algae. So scientists were like, hey, let's just breed a pig with less toxic waste. And that's what they did. EnviroPigs are pigs with up to 65% less phosphorus in their excrements. This pig was first created in 1999 at the University of Guelph's farm in Canada. This pig had its phytase gene attached to a piece of mouse DNA. Basically, in the end, it made the pig produce an enzyme to help it better digest plant phosphorus, which is a nutrient in its feed. Voila! From there, EnviroPigs were born. In our second spot, we have the Belgian Super Cow. Now, when they said Super Cow, they weren't joking, because take a load of this cow. It's monstrous. As many of you guys know, cows are my favorite animal, but this one terrifies me. It's massive. Like, look at its muscles. I'm sorry, but no animal should be as ripped as that. So basically, this super cow was created back in the 1800s when Belgian scientists and farmers mixed native cattle with shorthorn cattle. Then over the time, they would select the biggest and strongest offsprings of each variety and get them to breed together. So on and so on, bam, you got this super cow, which is definitely the biggest and strongest. So maybe let's stop doing that because this cow is soon gonna get too big for its own good and like take over the world or something. And in our number one spot, we have the human pig hybrid. Yes, this is a real thing. Scientists at the Salk Institute for Biological Sciences in California have created a human-pig hybrid. Now you're probably wondering, why on earth would they do this? Well, they did this in hopes that one day they could grow human organs inside of pigs and other animals instead of waiting for a donor. So in 2017, an embryo was placed in an adult pig for 4 weeks. Then this was taken out and analyzed. And the embryo survived and contained some human cells. Now they're going to figure out if pig embryos can handle enough human cells to create human organs. It's very creepy in my opinion.
At number 10, we have Camma. So we're gonna start off with Camma. This is a cross between a camel and a llama, or a comma, you could say. And while you may be thinking, okay, this isn't too wacky, I need to remind you the stats of both parents of this creature. A llama weighs about 130 to 200 kilograms, or 300 to 450 pounds. In comparison, a dromedary or one-humped camel weighs 400 to 600 kilograms. That's 900 to 1300 pounds, which is twice the size. So now we are all thinking, how? I will tell you that this blend was done sciencey through artificial means, and the biggest success story was Rama, or Rama, the Camma, or Camma, Rama the Camma, who lived to be 14 years old. And now that we've seen a Camma, let's look at another llama hybrid, the Swamma. This fake one. Ah, yes, majestic. I can imagine it now flying before nosediving when it sees I have snacks. Stunning. But on to another real one at number 9, Narluga. While this one wasn't caught on camera, we do have a photo of the skull. And there have been photoshopped interpretations of a Narluga. The skull was given to researchers by an Inuit hunter that was part of a group that caught 3 of these whales during a subsistence hunt. The blend of narwhal and beluga was described as uniformly gray with pectoral fins shaped like a beluga's and tail shaped like a narwhal's on sciencenews.org. It was confirmed through DNA analysis that the mother was a narwhal and the father was a beluga, and these have been said to not been spotted since this skull was discovered. But it is important to note that humans don't frequently visit the Arctic to whale watch for research or otherwise, so keep that in mind. And yes, I did promise it, have a funny photoshopped animal. This is a beluga horse hybrid, and again, majestic, but I'm kind of like judgy of the balance because it's kind of hard to believe it's like a bipedal animal but with has no arms, so like how would the balance work? I can barely balance with my two arms. Imagine the like, it's called a belugarse. You can name it for yourself if you like, but what if it falls forward? And then have another aquatic Arctic find, the penguin. This one's honestly creepy and it looks kind of like the villain in a story. So let's get back to the facts. At number 8, we have a hinny. And while you think hinny is just my bad impersonation of RuPaul, well, you're right, but it's something else as well. You may have heard of a mule, but a hinny is the other hybrid equine with similar parentage. Both a mule and a hinny are the result of breeding a horse with a donkey, but a mule has a horse as a mother and a hinny has a donkey as a mother. Let that sink in. Now, both tend to live longer than their parents and are more resistant to disease, but mules are more popular since they tend to be stronger and have better endurance. And now that I've told you about hinnies, let's look at this other fake blended creation, another equine, the horse seal. Moment of silence for how funny this one looks. That's one of my faves. At number 7, we have Zonkey. So if hinny wasn't wild enough for you here, for real life, have a Zonkey. A blend of a zebra and a donkey, and yeah, it's real. Quite rare though, because it's not as fertile of a species. Also because donkeys and zebras don't have the same number of chromosomes, so very rare. They look like their donkey parent in their physical stature and their zombie parent with their patterned fur, so aka a striped donkey. And while they are rare, they happen every once in a while when there's a love affair between a zebra and a donkey. Two equine species unalike in chromosomes in some fair zoo where we lay our scene. From ancient grudge break to new mutiny where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. Just Romeo and Juliet but with a donkey and a zebra. That was weird. Meh, take it. And it's not as dramatic as Romeo and Juliet, but let me have my moment here, okay? Here's your photo of something else. It's a shark horse. If this was running at you, what would you do? Let's go on to number 6, a leopon. So you've heard of a liger or a tigon, but what about this fanciful cat? It's a cross between a lioness and a leopard. This is one type of cross that's most likely happening in captivity, but not unheard of in the wild. This resulting look is a cat nearly the size of a lion with shorter legs like a leopard, and they have spots like a leopard's but are paler, more like brown instead of black, and males grow short manes, not the big luscious ones. And honestly, they look unreal and kind of fake, as if a lion was spray painted with jaguar spots and mane was given like a bit of a haircut, but super cool. And you know what else is cool? This line crossed between a lion and a guinea pig. A guinea lion. I'm trying to do an accent, I don't know what it is. I can't really imagine being afraid of it because like, look at the cute face, like no. Oh, but also look at this cute one, a squix. Just gosh darn adorable. But let's move on to number 5, Jeep, or Geep. No, I'm not talking about the car Jeep, this is about G-E-E-P, and I was probably right the second time saying it's a Geep. This hybrid is a chimera. In short, any Geep has 4 parents because it's the result of a combination of goat and sheep embryos. This mix of embryos is then put in the womb of a sheep or a goat until it's born. A successful Geep that was born had patches of sheepish wool and goatish hair. And whenever these are a success, they aren't able to have babies because goats and sheep have different numbers of chromosomes, as I've said before with the Zonkey. But another break from science talk, look at this Adani. It's so fluffy. It's amazing, it's from my wildest dreams and I want 10 of them. On to number 4, a zoe. This is spelled D-Z-O or D-Z-O. The zoe is a hybrid of a yak and a cow. And here's a yak for reference, and here's a cow for reference, and then the resulting zoe. Some people call it a yakow, which I think is great because it has a really nice ring to it, kind of like ka-chow. Anyways, a zoe has a face similar to a cow, but has larger horns, and it is larger than both of its parents. And my favorite fact that it can survive at an altitude of over 10,000 feet. Zoes have pulmonary artery pressure that's low, which means it can survive breathing in air without risking pulmonary hypertension, aka it has very low blood pressure, so the arteries have less problems. And you know what would give me less problems? Having a spowl. This beautiful fake creature, it's a spider owl. One, it has better eyeliner than me, and two, Is it spider-sized or owl-sized? I kinda wanna know, because I would take both, but for different reasons. On to number 3, a growler bear. And this blend is becoming increasingly more common, likely due to climate change. Grizzly bears moving further north into polar bear territory, and the two are mingling. One example looks like a grizzly in its face shape and its paws, but has mostly white color that polar bears are known for, because polar bears are white. And what is uncommon is the pair. This is a penguin bear hybrid about the size of a teddy bear and probably really great at catching salmon. Yes, it's fake. Slightly more common is the bowl, an owl bear hybrid. I said bowl, I meant bowel. An owl bear hybrid that is super jacked but wise at the same time. Again, fake. Still adorable. On to number 2, another real one, the wolfin. A wolfin is the result of a false killer whale breeding with a bottlenose dolphin. This and this. Now, this one is a bit misleading. A false killer whale is technically a dolphin species, but it's still a staggering pairing. A wolfin is much bigger than a bottlenose dolphin and a bit darker too. This pairing has been seen in captivity as well as in the wild, and a cool story is that there's a pair of parents of a wolfin, and they were both actually in an Adam Sandler movie, 50 First Dates. So the mother of the wolfin was Punaheli, and the father was Anui. If I'm pronouncing that wrong, I'm sorry, I tried. Here's another fake one, an elephant manatee, or fanatee if you will. Kind of brings snorkeling to a new level, and I can almost picture a fanatee just swinging its trunk and using it as a propeller to go forward. Kind of a funny visual. And I'll throw in another one, here's a sharkopotamus. I already knew that a hippo could crush like a 4 foot tall person in their jaws, so like adding that kind of like, it's kind of, if that was in real life I'd be afraid of it, but thank you for that, Giparama, for providing that visual. But let's go on to number 1, scary animal hybrid. Killer bees. Now, this is a bee that was originally a hybrid of the African lowland honeybee with various other European honeybees. This cross became known as the Africanized bee. It was produced originally with the hopes of creating a bee with higher honey production, which is great intent, but instead it resulted in a more defensive bee. Victims of killer bee stings tend to receive 10 times more stings than from European honeybees, and during the original process of hybridizing, 26 swarms escaped the quarantine where they were produced in Brazil. And that was back in 1957, and the hybrid was spotted in North America by 1985, and the south of Texas by 1990. So, that's real. But let's go on to something else. This is a hybrid of a ferret and a duck. So obviously a ferret, right?
Going off at number 10 now, we have the Vicente mouse. There's no easy way to say this. The Vicente mouse was a mouse with a human ear on its back. Well, not technically. The ear mouse was created by Charles Vicente and his colleagues at the University of Massachusetts in 1997. The ear on its back was actually an ear-shaped piece of cartilage grown by seeding cow cartilage cells into a biodegradable ear-shaped mold that was then implanted underneath the mouse's skin. But yeah, it's an ear, basically. So what was the point of all of this? Well, when the picture started circulating around the internet in the late 1990s, many people used it in protests against genetic engineering. However, no genetic manipulation was actually performed here. The whole point was to show that transplantation of fabricated cartilage into humans is possible. We have the Vicente mouse to thank for that, even if it does look very weird. Next up at number 9 now, we have the see-through frog. I love this one. In 2007, Japanese researchers succeeded in producing see-through frogs. The reason, so that they didn't have to kill and dissect them anymore in order to study their organs, blood vessels, and eggs. How amazing is that? In modern times, dissections have become increasingly controversial. Many animal rights activists have called for more humane methods of studying frogs without having to perform dissections. Lead researcher Masayuki Sumida said, "You can watch organs of the same frog over its entire life as you don't have to dissect it." The researcher can also observe how toxins affect bones, livers, and other organs at lower costs. These frogs were created from rare mutants of the natural Japanese brown frog. They bred pale frogs together until the offspring were completely translucent. At the time, the researchers also said they could inject the frogs with an illuminating protein that would cause parts of the frog to glow when cancer starts. Imagine if they did that with humans. Interesting, but perhaps a little bit creepy. Moving on to number 8 now, we have Dolly the sheep. Some of you may have heard of this one before. Dolly was was a sheep. She was also the first mammal to be cloned from an adult cell. She was born in Scotland after scientists from the University of Edinburgh did years of research and failed attempts. She was created using the technique of somatic cell nuclear transfer, where the cell's nucleus from an adult cell is transferred into an unfertilized egg cell that's had its nucleus removed. The cell is then stimulated to develop by an electric shock. The cell was then implanted into a surrogate mother and was eventually born into a healthy, normal-looking. The cell was then implanted into a surrogate mother and eventually became a healthy, normal-looking sheep called Dolly. It's a risky procedure and often results in stillborns or calves that last just a few days or weeks. However, Dolly was stable. The scientists waited almost 7 months to announce her to the world, but when they did, the news was everywhere. Many people called it the breakthrough of the year. This cloning paved the way for other large animal clones such as pigs, deer, horses, and bulls. In January 2018, scientists even successfully cloned macaque monkeys, the first primates ever cloned. Is human cloning around the corner? Next up at number 7 now, we have the glowfish. These are fish that glow in the dark. They aren't locked away in some lab away from the public eye. You can buy them. They are on the market. They are 100% for sale. In 1999, scientists in Singapore took the glowing gene of a jellyfish and inserted it into the embryo of an Indian zebrafish. The result? Was glowfish. They glow in both natural and ultraviolet light. This wasn't the ultimate goal for the scientists. They actually wanted to develop a fish that could detect water pollution by glowing in the presence of environmental toxins. They were then approached by Yorktown Technologies, who bought the right to sell the fish worldwide. They are sold in bright red, green, orange, yellow, blue, and purple fluorescent colors. Their names include electric green, moonrise pink, cosmic blue, and galactic purple. The FDA approved them for sale in the US once they assessed that they were not going to end up in the food chain. But still, if you see one, maybe don't eat it. That's just my advice for today. Next up at number 6 now, we have Ruppy. In 2009, scientists at Seoul National University created the world's first transgenic dog. Her name was Ruppy, and she glowed under ultraviolet light. Of course, the gene to glow in UV doesn't naturally occur in dogs. They got the gene from sea anemones. Ruby was created by cloning fibroblast cells that express a red fluorescent gene produced by the sea anemones. It was hoped that transgenic dogs like Ruppy would become effective stand-ins for the study of human diseases. Professor Lee Byung-chun led the research team and said, "What's significant in this work is not the dogs expressing red colors, but that we planted genes into them." Of course, he can say that, but the media and the world became obsessed with the idea of a dog that glowed when you shone a UV light on it. Other scientists criticized the process, saying transgenesis is laborious, expensive, and slow. Moving on to number 5 now, we have the sudden death mosquitoes. That's the name that's been given to these mosquitoes because essentially scientists have engineered them to possibly bring an end to their own species. Sounds crazy? This is how it works. They genetically modified male mosquitoes with lethal genes. Once released, the males mate with the females in the wild and release these lethal genes, which kills them or kills the offspring before they can develop into adulthood. If successful, techniques like this could wipe out huge swathes of mosquito populations around the world or even bring them to extinction. The result isn't just because mosquitoes are annoying, it's to stop them from spreading the likes of dengue fever, which has no known cure and has put nearly half of the world's population at risk of infection. Of course, this is good news for humans. 2.3 million infections and 25,000 deaths could be prevented every single year. However, as bad as they are, some people are questioning whether humans have the right to intentionally kill off mosquitoes, an entire species. What do you guys think? Coming at number 4 now, we have the fast-growing salmon. In 2015, America's FDA approved Aqua Advantage salmon for human consumption. These are Atlantic salmon with an added gene which allows them to grow all year round instead of only during spring and summer. The intention has been to increase the speed at which the fish grows without affecting its ultimate size or other qualities. These fish can now reach their market size in 16 to 18 months instead of the usual 3 years. Despite the approval by the FDA and other governments around the world, it's unlikely that you'll be finding these special salmon everywhere. Back when they were approved, there was just two land-based facilities that were allowed to grow the fish. One day, though, they could become the norm. Next up at number three now, we have the EnviroPig, a name that I absolutely love. In 2010, researchers at the University of Guelph created genetically engineered pigs dubbed the EnviroPig. Now, on the surface, they look just like normal pigs, but it's not about the outside, it's about what's going on inside them. You see, normal pigs produce a lot of phosphorus in their urine and feces. That then finds its way into lakes, rivers, and oceans, causing algae blooms. The outburst of algae rapidly depletes the water's oxygen levels, creating vast dead zones that kill fish and other aquatic life. Not good. Pigs are often blamed for contributing to exactly this. These specially engineered EnviroPigs produce up to 65% less phosphorus in their urine and feces. This would make things better for the environment, but also for farmers. You see, many farmers had to abide by strict laws that allow no farms to release nitrogen or phosphorus runoffs. They usually have to store all the waste and wait for it to be treated and recycled as fertilizer. This is all just added costs for farmers. It's hoped that the EnviroPigs could change all that and do some good for the environment at the same time. Moving on to number two now, we have the sterile pink bollworm. Pink bollworms are a nightmare for cotton farmers. Every year they destroy cotton crops around the world. It got so bad that the US Department of Agriculture began tests to see if they could stop the worms in their tracks. They began growing a lot of pink bollworms in laboratories. That might sound counterproductive if your aim is to reduce their numbers, but wait. The male bollworms had actually been genetically engineered to be totally sterile, meaning even if they mated with a female, no offspring would come about. The worms were then released back into the natural population, where they competed with wild male bollworms for the females. Scientists hope that if enough of these sterile males mate with the females, the number of offspring would be greatly reduced, providing some relief for cotton farmers around the world. And finally, at number one now, we have the see-through goldfish. In 2009, Japanese researchers succeeded in creating a goldfish that was so translucent you can see its heart beating inside its body. The aim was to create a fish that could be studied without the need for a dissection, the same reason for the frogs that we talked about earlier. Yutaka Tamaru, a professor of the study, said, "You don't have to cut it open. You can see a tiny brain above the goldfish's black eyes." Scientists created the fish using selective breeding. They took two natural fish who had slightly paler skin than the rest and bred them together. They continued like this with the offspring until the skin became so pale it was see-through. The fish are expected to live up to 20 years. They can grow as long as 10 inches and weigh more than 6 pounds. That's much bigger than fish used in similar experiments. They hope that for the people studying these fish, they can now see their whole life cycle take place underneath their see-through skin without ever having to hurt them.